Good morning and welcome. It's great to see you all here today. We have a few reminders for you. Please keep your mask on during mass, covering your nose and mouth. The offertory basket is now located on the table inside the front entrance or the entrance door. Communion will be distributed at the end of mass. Please follow the directions of the ushers. The only the priest will distribute communion on the tongue. Please inform the usher and go to the end of that line. Take all your belongings with you to communion, as you will not be returning to your seat. If you are not receiving communion, remain in the communion line until you reach the priest, and then respectfully exit. When it's your turn to receive, stop 6 feet from the minister. Keep your mask on while the minister shows you the host and says, "The body of Christ." Then, after you respond, "Amen," approach the minister with outstretched arms to receive. After you receive the host in your hand, then step 6 feet to the side, away from the minister. There you will loosen your mask to consume the host, replace your mask, and exit the church. Please stand.
Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, what I have done and what I have failed to do. St. Anthony of Padua to your people as an outstanding preacher and as an intercessor in their need, grant that with his assistance, as we follow the teachings of the Christian life, we may know your help in every trial. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. Elijah set out and came along Elisha, son of Shaphat. As he was plowing the 12 yoke of oxen, he was following the 12th. Elijah went over to him and threw his cloak over him. Elisha left the oxen, ran after Elijah, and said, "Please, let me kiss my father and mother goodbye, and I will follow you." Elijah said, "Go back. Have I done anything to you?" Elisha left him, and taking the yoke of oxen, slaughtered them. He used the plowing equipment for fuel to boil their flesh, and he gave it to his people to eat. Then he left and followed Elisha as his attendant. The word of the Lord.
Amen.
Our response is, "You are my inheritance, O Lord.
You are my inheritance, O Lord.
Keep me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, my Lord are you. O Lord, my allotted portion and my cup. You it is who hold fast my lot.
You are my inheritance, O Lord.
I bless the Lord who counsels me. Even in the night, my heart exhorts me. I set the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed.
You are my inheritance, O Lord.
Therefore, my heart is glad and my soul rejoices. My body, too, abides in confidence, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your faithful one to undergo corruption.
You are my inheritance, O Lord.
Lord be with you.
With your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "You have heard that it was said to your ancestors, 'Do not take a false oath, but make good to the Lord all that you vow.' But I say to you, do not swear at all, not by heaven, for it is God's throne, nor by the earth, for it is his footstool, nor by Jerusalem, for it is the city of the great king. Do not swear by your head, for you cannot make a single hair white or black. Let your yes mean yes, and your no mean no. Anything more is from the evil one." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Saint Anthony of Padua, or as they say up in Wilmington, Saint Anthony, is one of the most popular saints in our church. So popular because he is a wonder worker, such as helping find lost or stolen articles. Something we need to remember with Saint Anthony is to give gratitude after he's helped us, okay? Usually we're so excited we just after we found something. Saint Anthony, whose real name is Fernando, was born in the year 1195, and he was born into a wealthy family in Portugal. And he studied at the local Catholic school, and when he was 15 years old, he joined a monastery, but friends and family kept visiting him and distracted him, so he moved to the monastery further away to study his theology and Latin. He would encounter some Franciscans who were on their way to get the bodies of Franciscans who were martyred for the faith in North Africa. And they were also to go and preach and convert the Muslims to Christ and Christianity. This would motivate Fernando to become a Franciscan, who at the time the Franciscans were a new order, and he would change his name to Anthony. Anthony would spend some time in Morocco preaching the faith, but he would get very sick and would be sent back to Portugal to heal. Well, a huge storm came, and his boat ended up over in Sicily. That's a long way from where he was, so call it serendipity. The Lord had a plan. Anthony was placed in a monastery there in Sicily to get better, and he would then be sent to northern Italy. While in the north of Italy, the situation happened, which made Anthony the patron saint of lost articles, would happen. So he had this book of Psalms, and he had all these notes in it. You know, you have one of those books, and you're like, oh, I really want that, you know? Because you can't just buy it, because you spent all this time making these notes. So he started praying, and a novice who had taken the book to read started feeling really guilty, and he chose to bring it back for Anthony. And that's how the whole lost article gift thing started. Anybody know that story before today? You get extra credit in heaven now. So, the next major thing to happen, which is a credit to him becoming so famous, is that Anthony went to an ordination of some Dominicans and Franciscans. After the meal, the provincial suggested that one of the friars give a short homily. Of course, priests being priests, they hadn't prepared. They're all like dodging, trying not to be seen. And so Anthony drew the short straw per se when asked to give a short reflection, and he was excellent. And he was assigned to preach to the public in northern Italy because many had been falling away from the faith. People, though, would not listen to him, and as legend has it, he went and preached to the fish, and thousands of fish came to the surface to listen to him. Well, this really people thought it was awesome. They went and they saw it, and they saw that it was actually happening, and his miracle brought many people back to the faith. Within a year after his passing, Anthony was canonized as saint, and that's not very common. I think there's only been a couple who have been canonized within the first year. 30 years after his death and burial, his body was exhumed, and his tongue was to have been perfectly intact, and people saw this as a sign of his wonderful preaching ability. So, in closing, as I said, remember, St. Anthony does help. If you're finding something, don't forget to give gratitude for this very storied and helpful saint. Amen.
With hope rooted in faith, we turn to Almighty God with our prayers and petitions. For those discerning priesthood or religious life, may the Holy Spirit strengthen them and give them wisdom in their decision-making. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For state and federal legislators, may God inspire them in enacting policies that support human life and dignity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those suffering from despair, may God's peace comfort them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For members of this faith community, may the Holy Spirit fill us with a zeal for evangelization. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those suffering from coronavirus and family and friends of those members, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, may they enjoy eternal life in paradise. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And at this Mass, we especially remember Melvin Wilhide. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Merciful Father, kindly hear the prayers we bring to you today through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands it will become our spiritual drink. Sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, the offerings placed on your altar in commemoration of Blessed Anthony of Padua, so that as you brought him glory, you may, through these sacred mysteries, grant to us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Anthony of Padua, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthened her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. So with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without without end, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Anne, St. Juan Diego, St. Anthony of Padua, and with all the saints. Under his constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Francis, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you after passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of God, and the glory of the Lord, is to come and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
we give you glory, the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, we take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, pray for us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May partaking at the heavenly table, Almighty God, confirm and increase strength from on high, and all who celebrate the feast day of Blessed Anthony of Padua, that we may preserve in integrity the gift of faith and walk in the path of salvation you trace for us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.